Instead of asking if a food pairs with whiskey, why not ask yourself what story you want to tell as an experience? I first linked whiskey and food at a molecular level back in 2012 and called it Marrying Malts and Molecules. As a science curious foodie, I wanted to provide more confidence in whiskey food pairing. Now it's time to drill down in the science at a molecular level, so let's dive in. Hello, Hendo here, and welcome to How to Marry Malts and Molecules. In this video, you will discover the chemistry behind your favourite drams. To learn more about pairing sensory science with a global perspective, please like this video, subscribe, and click the notification bell for more insights. Tell us in the comments your favourite whiskey styles and aromas. If you're not already familiar with molecular pairing, I have some more videos to watch. I'll put the links up here. This is a more scientific approach to Scotch whisky food pairing. Let's look at what we know. To be called Scotch whisky, it must be aged in oak barrel for at least 3 years, and about 70% of the flavour profile is going to come from the oak cask. So we need to dig deeper into this. Then there's the sensory perception. According to research, 80-90% of appetite stimulation is coming from the fragrance. The aroma plays such a dominant role in our taste perception. Although there's 200 species of oak, the main oak in Scotch whisky is going to be American white oak, usually ex-bourbon, from 80% of all Scotch whisky spends time, and European oak, often ex-sherry. So just two styles then? No, there's so much more going on. Scotch whisky is one of the most complex liquids in the world, with over 400 aromatic volatile compounds. The nuances of region, the peat level, coastal notes, sherry influences, these are the results of processes in production and creates a myriad of flavours to explore. Maturation, age, the cask, shape and size, has the cask been first filled, second filled, and rejuvenation techniques. Some older whiskies are refreshed into newer sherry casks to freshen the spirit in a finish. Or dechar and rechar technique to scrape back the cask interior surface to new wood to be retoasted or recharred, helping to retain the spirit character after maturation. There's char grading, and heavy char creates layers of charcoal which acts as a filtration system. So depending on the cask and how the lignins break down, you can see it yields different notes. French oak packs 9 times more tannic acid than American oak, and in American white oak you'll find notes of vanilla, caramel, spice, smoke, coffee and chocolate. At this point I need to introduce a key element to marrying malts and molecules. It's called the Mayard reaction. No, not the duck, but named after the French scientist who discovered it in 1912, Louis-Camille Mayard. This is flavour producing reactions, a browning effect, cooking in high temperatures, 250 to 300 degrees Fahrenheit, amino acid on sugar, as opposed to caramelisation, which is sugar on sugar. The Mayard reaction, you can see here, is a key chemical reaction creating flavours and aromas. In the whisky making, this is when malting the barley and also toasting, charring the casks. So it's a very important part of the process. Grilled meats, roasted coffee, toasted bread, chocolate, barbecue flavours. Find a Mayard reaction and you find the foundations to a good marriage of whisky pairing. If you remember one thing, this is it. Flavours born in fire. However, there are more tools at your disposal. Now, you might be familiar with this vast array of tasting notes, like this flavour wheel by the Scotch Whisky Research Institute, categorised by groups of key aromas and flavours you can see here. But what if we used our nose to identify these notes and somehow correlate them to actual chemical compounds? Like this here. Esters, phenols, aldehydes. Out of 400 aroma compounds, we'll really only pick out about a dozen or so. If your nose can pick out specific scents like coconut, woody, vanilla notes, that might indicate ex-bourbon barrel, because this is from the lactone family of aromatic volatile compounds found richly in American white oak. The coconut lactone. American oak is known for having sweeter toasted character than European oak, which does not contain the lactones. So here's a start. We have whiskey lactones, named because it was first identified in whiskey. They display a coconut, apricot or peaches character. Now these lactones naturally occur in other foods such as wine, apricots, pineapple, wheat, bread, black tea and coconut itself. So now this becomes a pathway, the keys to new harmonies, which can sometimes lead to surprising combinations. See here, the toasted coconut crumbled arancini sitting on a whiskey glass, containing ex-bourbon cask Scotch whisky. The lactone aromas envelop your taste experience in the perfect marriage. Or this dark chocolate blue cheese ganache shells, which works very well with Ugeonal rich sherry casks. To decipher this clearly, I created a system or a way to simplify thousands of whiskey expressions, like in this diagram of key aroma families found in whiskey. Aldehydes are present in crops, have leafy qualities like fresh cut grass, herbal notes. Furfural is caramel, nutty and malty, almondy notes, benzylaldehyde. In food, beef and terpenes and rosemary. So a wide range of aromas to work with aldehydes. You can see eugenols, spicy notes and cloves from the European oak, predominant in sherry casks. Eugenols are also found in foods like malted barley, basil, mango, strawberries, pineapple, beef. So this can lead to many recipes. Now esters, very important when distillers test the new make spirit. They look for high esters because they'll provide rich fruit notes in the final spirit. They are still in the lactone family, but I separate for clarity. Banana pear drop aromas and the cloudy element in non-chill filtered whiskies. Linalool compound identifies the floral notes, bergamot or lavender. Is also found in citrus and cinnamon esters of the floral notes. Phenols you'll find in smoky whiskey, medicinal notes, guaiacol and syringol are the smoky compounds, but also found in vanilla, vanillin, a phenolic aldehyde. Furans are an aroma compound of the bread, the malty bread, and maltol is in the malted barley, but also in charred casks as the lignins break down. Burnt sugar, caramel notes, candy floss aroma, and found in toasted bread. So much going on in these flavours born in fire. As you swing open Pandora's box, remember this. To unlock or bridge flavour, think about the story you want to tell. Then have a look at the ingredients and turbocharge your recipes with key herbs and spices that can harmonise with your whiskey. This, my friends, is how to approach more confidence in pairing. The examples here show this. I've created hundreds of recipes for functions and events around the world and often had to quickly create pairings at very short notice for clients and chef teams on the ground. So you assess the whiskey and pick out aroma compounds. You can create pairings in both directions, whiskey first or food first. As you like, you can see many bite-sized canapés are a good way to go if you're having a few whiskies. Grilled steak with a sherry bomb whiskey is excellent. Also consider the whiskey strength, and if you dilute, bear in mind whiskey undergoes chemical changes with the addition of water or ice, unlike wine. The character changes in dilution and cooling. It can release entrapped flavour compounds, which can enhance your taste perception. Perhaps try your whiskey served first, depending on where you are in the world, and the climate might help decide your choices here. So, to wrap things up, please please take these key flavour bridges, go and explore new taste sensations, and tell us what you think. Share your pairing ideas in the comments. I hope you find this useful in some way, and until next time, thanks very much for watching.